So welcome to Biology 1010. Normally I'd be giving this intro in person, but because of the changes that we are making in the school temporarily, these classes being online, I want you to at least see the face of the person you're going to hear behind those PowerPoints that you're going to be listening to and the videos you're going to be watching and things of that sort, so you know me as your professor. So I'm Dr. Bradshaw, and I've designed the course to essentially take you through general biology. And this course is set up so that you learn all of the fundamentals for your general biology. And I'm gonna walk you through Canvas a little bit and help you out. But a lot of this, you're gonna have to go at your own pace. It's gonna be structured in a way that you won't be able to finish everything in 1 week. It is going to be paced, but you won't be able to go ahead too much. And that's because of some of the assignments and discussions that I've set up for you to be able to take online, as well as to be able to get feedback so that you can ask questions of me during the semester instead of just feeling like you're alone, feeling like you have no one to help you. I mean, that's the whole reason why I'm here. And so when you get to the home page of the course, you'll notice that you have course information set up with the syllabus and instructor information and lecture files. Make sure you read through the syllabus. It's basically outlining everything that I'm going to summarize for you, but it gives in greater detail. So make sure that you go through that. Also with the instructor information and office hours and how we meet. Again, it all has to be virtual. And that's outlined in that as well. But fundamentally, when you have questions, there are times set apart, and you can schedule times with me so that we can meet virtually. I can answer your questions. You can do it through email. You can do it through, you know, any resources available. You can do it on the discussion boards and post things. But fundamentally, you need to know that I'm here to be able to help you through this course. This isn't just you watching videos, taking quizzes, and not getting any help from me. I will be available throughout the entire course to be able to answer your questions. Now, the lecture files, that's all of my PowerPoints. That's all of the things you're gonna see as you watch the videos and as you hear my voice. So make sure you either download those or access those, because they're gonna really help. Also, made available to you are an outline of my notes. This is kind of a precursor to get you started. So make sure that you have those as well, because they delineate exactly what you need to know for the quizzes in terms of the topics. Now, as far as the quizzes goes, make sure that you watch the reviews for each lecture, because these lecture videos were created to be very general. But because my quiz questions change a little bit over the years, I have to update these reviews. Now, normally these reviews are done in class, but the digital or lectures that you're going to see, these are updated for the latest quizzes that you're going to have. So make sure you listen to those, because they're really going to help you hone in on what's going to be on the quizzes and whatnot. So don't shortcut yourself in anything. Make sure you got all of the outline notes. Make sure you have all of the PowerPoint lectures so you can follow along and take notes and whatnot, just like you would a normal class, as if you're just sitting in class and listening to the lecture. The only difference is we won't be able to have a dialogue during that, but we can have a dialogue afterwards during what we normally would have spent the time as a class going through all of this material. In each section, there's going to be some additional videos. These are not required, but these additional videos are meant to help solidify some of the concepts and the ideas. And so you can watch those, you don't have to, but they're meant to help you. And then, of course, each lecture will have a quiz and a discussion. And the discussions are meant to help you also prepare for the quiz, but also have a general discussion with the class about some of these more critical thinking concepts and ideas. And each one is very specific for each lecture, really gets to you thinking outside of the box and applying what you're learning. And that's really the whole point of this general biology class, is to see how biology applies in the everyday world. And that's what these discussions are designed to do. You will have one assignment, and this assignment is a fairly simple one. It's a report that you're going to do some research with and write up, but that's not due till the end of the semester. And so that one's more of a semester-long project that will give you some extra points if you do well on it, just to be able to allow you some additional insight into how biology applies. But generally, the rhythm of the course will be that every few weeks, you'll have several lectures in which you need to listen to, complete, take the quizzes, learn what you've made mistakes on, and then retake the quizzes, and then you move on to the next section. And so I found in my experience that if I just open it up and let you take it at your pace, a lot of people do well, but some just, for whatever reason, don't pace themselves. They get to the end of the semester, they have all this work to do, it's too much, it's overwhelming, and so this way, it breaks it up for you so that you can complete it. It does cause a little bit of stress in terms of time frames and whatnot. I say a little, it's not a lot, because you'll have several weeks to complete multiple lectures, and that way it gives you periodic time tables in which to complete the work so that you can complete it without having to scramble all the way at the end. Okay. So as we go through here again, I'm just going to kind of give you a brief overview. The first set of lectures are on how life is organized. And so you're going to find that they're very simple. They're very straightforward. There's not a lot of complexity to them. They're designed to teach you how, you know, atoms form molecules and how water is important for life and what are the organic molecules of life. They're designed to teach you the scientific method and kind of just give you that overview. So they're very rudimentary. They're meant to be easy, meaning if you don't do well on these first four quizzes or so, that has more to do with how you're approaching the quizzes and learning the material rather than the material itself. The material should be very easy. Now, that's done on purpose because I want to ease you into this so that you're not feeling overwhelmed, especially with the biology class. So make sure that if you are struggling in these first few, that you right away get extra help from me, from other resources at UVU, from people in your class with the discussion groups. That's what, you know, that first part is designed to do, is to ease you into this, because they will get harder. Now, I'm not saying exponentially harder. I'm just saying they'll get harder, because as you start going into the next group of subjects, which is on how life uses energy, I find that that section tends to be the most difficult for everybody because it has to do with concepts like photosynthesis and glucose metabolism and the laws of physics and things like that that you have to learn. And that's not always the easiest subjects. So again, there's additional helps. There's videos that will help, you know, solidify the concepts. But those are the ones to look out for. Those kind of take a next level up. After that, everything is pretty much about that same difficulty, but people find that when they jump to that section, it tends to be much harder. And so just keep an eye on that. That's about lecture 7 that you're going to start seeing things jump up a little bit harder. And then from the rest of the semester, they tend to stay about that level of difficulty. After how life uses energy, you're going to learn about genetics. You're going to learn about reproduction. These are key concepts of biology. Those tend to be a little bit more enjoyable because you learn about subjects like cancer and sexual reproduction and inheritance and things like that. And there's a lot more application. And because it applies to human physiology and other things, people tend to do much better on it because it's stuff we understand already. And you're just really applying some new concepts to that. And then we finish the semester off with evolution. And the last few lectures are looking at how evolution and ecology go hand in hand, what are the principles of evolution, and so on and so forth. And so that's the general concepts and the flow of the class. Obviously, as you look at the syllabus, you can see exactly what each lecture is about. And as you listen to each lecture, again, they are clearly defined in the information that you need to learn. The final exam is comprehensive, but it also has its own lecture. So if you look at the final exam as kind of a double quiz, then you can approach it that way as well. You don't have to actually go back to every single quiz and relearn every little concept. The final exam review will actually cover all the concepts that you basically need to know for the final exam. So don't stress that because it's comprehensive, you have to remember every last little fact. Generally, these are concepts that we want you to leave with a understanding of how biology applies to everyday life, and they are condensed and they are consolidated. So it is comprehensive, but it doesn't require that you remember everything that you've learned throughout the semester, okay? The final exam isn't weighted any differently than the other quizzes. It's 20 questions, and your quizzes are 10 questions. So it's like a double quiz. Now, quizzes are timed, so make sure that you study before you take them because you don't have unlimited time to take them. They are randomized in terms of which questions you get, so no two people get the exact same quiz, but the concepts are the same. The way the questions are grouped together, you'll always get the same concepts. Like, for example, with lecture one, everyone will get a question on cell theory, they'll get a couple questions on reproduction, they'll get a couple questions on evolution. You know, lecture one is basically an overview, what I just went through with you. It just kind of summarizes everything that I just talked about and gives you a few concepts to think about and to learn. And so everyone will get the same concepts, but I've written maybe 60 to 100 questions per quiz. And the way that the computer pulls from it is it will randomize which questions you get. So they're all of the same level difficulty in terms of groupings. Some are easier than others, but they're grouped together so that everybody gets that same easy question. Some are more difficult, but those are grouped together so that everybody gets the same type of critical thinking questions and things like that. Okay. Again, if you have any questions, even starting off with this class, just send me an email or post a discussion on Canvas for everyone to see. We want to make this as immersive and interactive as possible. Some people will go through this class without talking to anybody, and that's their choice. Others will need a lot of additional help, and that's why I'm here, and that's why your classmates are here. We need to simulate the in-classroom setting as best as we possibly can to help it be as successful for everybody, okay? Because some can work autonomously. Even during a normal semester, I'll have people that won't show up to class and they'll do fine. And that's just how they work, is they're able to read through the book, listen to the lectures, but not really participate. Others really need to participate to be able to get all the help that they need. So do what you need to do to be successful in this class. If that means contacting me, setting up office hours, meeting with me virtually, setting up discussions with your fellow classmates to be able to study beforehand, all of those types of things, okay? So as you read through, it's pretty simple. Make sure you know what dates things are due. Each groupings of lectures are in what we call modules. And these basically have due dates, and they say it right on the under the lecture quiz. In fact, you should be able to navigate to everything just from the home page. You shouldn't have to click on anything else on the left side of Canvas. You should just be able to go back to home and be able to complete everything in the course as it's displayed right in front of you. It just kind of goes in order from top to bottom in terms of assignments and when they're due. So as you go down the list, just make sure you've covered everything in each module, in each lecture, the discussion, the quiz, watched any videos in addition to the lecture and the quiz review that you need to do. And hopefully this will be an enjoyable and successful semester being online. But here I am. I'm Dr. Bradshaw. I'm here to help you so that you see my face and know that you're not just taking this course from an AI generated or, you know, something that's just left and done. Okay, so I'm here for you. Make sure you utilize all resources available that have been posted, and hopefully we'll have a great semester.